Good evening. My name is Orlando Benzon, and I am one of the assistant principals here at Brockport High School. Thank you all for coming out tonight. Just a few housekeeping things before we get started. Please take the time to look around the auditorium and recognize where your exits are. We have exits in the front and the rear of the auditorium. The exit closest to you may not necessarily be the one that you came in through the front, so just keep that in mind. At this time, I ask that you silence your cell phones. You are more than welcome to take video. If you're going to take pictures, please make sure your flash is off. If you need to exit the auditorium at any time, please try to do so in between the pieces, not while our students are performing. That would be greatly appreciated. With that shared, I would like to introduce you or welcome you to the spring jazz concert, and we will start the evening with the Handsome Devils.
So good evening. Thanks for coming here tonight. We've got another chart for you from the Handsome Devils, but I just wanted to honor and talk a little bit about the group. They have worked very hard this year. It's always a building year, but I think they're the most dedicated at coming and working together. If they need extra time together, they put it together. They find a time in the day, and nobody's afraid to jump in and play a piano part or whatever is needed to get it together, because I can't always be with them. So thank you for working together. You're good role models with that and good musicians. I did want to say our seniors that are leaving, Brennan and Cole, have been devoted to this group for 4 years. Awesome. Really, really nice leadership and dedication to this kind of singing. So congratulations to all of them, but especially to our seniors. And Jake is going to give us a pitch for The Glory of Love, and then we'll move on to the next group. So here is Glory of Love.
Out. Hello, everybody. Introducing Brockport High School Jazz Ensemble. That first piece was On the Sunny Side of the Street, arranged by Sammy Nestico, and we had a trumpet solo in there, Christopher Guthrie. I do want to make a mention on a name that wasn't in the program. This year I've had an opportunity to work for the first time ever as a director with a jazz violinist. This student has been with us all year, playing anything from flute parts to bass lines to piano melodies. And I just want to introduce her, Alice Dickerson, right here. Stand up. It's been a pleasure working with her. Thank you. Graham Wisnowski, blues guitar. That one was called Blues for the Cat. Thank you. Aspen Culp, Raylan Gingrich. That was Night in Tunisia by Dizzy Gillespie. This is the BHS Jazz Ensemble.
lightning hit me, the thunder roared, and baby, I ain't never felt like this before.
It went ooh, flash. It went ooh, bam. Alakazam.
A rubber cover, I'll love you like no other, I'll take good care of you.
One look and I yell, timber, watch out for flying glass. Cause the ceiling fell in and the bottom fell out, I went into a spin and I started to shout, I've been hit. This is it, this is it, pow. I was walking along, minding my business, when love came and hit me in the eye. It went flash, bam, alakazam. I've been orange colored, purple striped, pretty green polka dotted sky. Flash, bam, alakazam. It's goodbye. Oh yeah.
Okay. So here we are with our jazz group, Mad Vocals, and I have a couple thank yous before we go too much further. You've seen a lot of kids doing things around here, right, to help out with running the show. So I just wanted to recognize Jenna Rivera, who's working lights and sound tonight. Thank you so much, Jenna, and she'll be singing in a little while. And I appreciate the flexibility Cole Macedi has to just bring mics up and back and stuff. This is nice to have, and it's nice to have our streaming CPACS people here so that people at home can be hearing this and seeing the great things that all these kids do. So we just noticed that with microphones, it goes through the live broadcast better. But we only have these, so there you go. But thanks, guys. Thanks so much to you for coming here tonight. This is a really supportive community of music lovers, and I don't know that you know how special that is. I don't see that in other places. People don't talk about how faithful their community is, and I just want to make sure you know we appreciate you being here. It's fun to sing for you and to perform for you. So thank you for being here tonight. I want to say thanks to our administration, Mr. Benzon, for being here tonight, and all of our K-12 administrator and district office and school board. You know, this stuff doesn't happen without their support, so we thank you very much. And of course, our K-12 department. It's been a wild month in May. Oh, and now we're in June, and we're still not done with concerts, right? Did you notice the back? And to see how the program just develops from fourth grade on up is really exciting, and so we're happy to be here tonight, and it's a great group of people to work with. So we're gonna sing one more for you, but I just wanna recognize our seniors. We've got Patty, who came to us this year for the first time, and we really appreciate our senior Patty, who adds so much to what we do. So thanks, Patty. Yeah, we can clap for her. Sunny showed up. We were on the stage, right? It was one of those every other day learning things, right? And we had to be 12 feet apart, and you showed up and stayed. So thanks for coming to be here with us for 3 years, Sunny. And Riley and Cole showed up together as freshmen. And so they've been here for 4 years, scatting away sometimes, and but leading the sections and swinging hard when we've got to. So thanks so much for your dedication over 4 years, the two of you. Okay, so everybody knows Phil Collins, right? No Jacket Required tour, twice. London, the Prince and Princess were in the box, the royal boxes. It was pretty cool because I got to see Phil Collins. Well, he put this together for Disney, Trash in the Camp. It was in the Tarzan movie. Let's see if they can groove as much as Phil Collins and who was that other group? NSYNC. I'm learning still. So let's see if we can groove like they did. Awesome. Trash in the Camp. We've got solos by, let me just remember, Phoebe, Riley, I'm going down, Julia, and Kirsten. Is that all the solos? Oh, and then we've got a senior trio at the end of the senior soprano altos. So Patty and Sunny and Riley will be up here singing a trio. So here we go. And now you see they're going to go change clothes a little bit, and they're going to get to Blue Notes. We're done, right? Yeah. Okay, Blue Notes is up next. You'll see them come back in different forms. So the microphone.
Thank you so much, and thank you for bearing with us as we make all these transitions. I'm sure you've seen many of these faces already on the stage or in the pit tonight, so thank you again for your patience as we transition here. That was called Follow Me Like the Moon. It was performed originally by Sammy Ray and the Friends, and every year here at Brockport in the band program, we rotate commission projects, and it's been a couple of years since we did that because of COVID, and this was the first year I wanted to do this. And bring it back for the Blue Notes, and we asked, it's special to ask an alumni, Joey Stempien, who arranged this for us, and he's sitting right over there. So Joe, stand up. Thank you very much, Joey. All right, this next tune we're gonna play is entitled Alexander's Ragtime Band, but I'm gonna step away for a moment and let Mr. Andy Stoker come up here and tell you a little bit about this piece and sort of the sentimental value behind this for the Blue Notes and him. So welcome to the pit here, Mr. Andy Stoker.
So like Tori was just talking about, starting in, I think it was 2000 or 2001, Mr. Hallquist and I started this commission project. And one of the first people that we talked to about doing a commission was Howard Rowe. Howard had written a ton of music for every age ensemble, jazz ensemble, concert bands, orchestras, I don't think he did any choral works. He was smart enough to avoid that. that was for Liz, if she's listening. So there you go, Liz. He was one of our first people, I think maybe in 2003 or four, and Sean and I would contact people that we knew first, then we kind of did some cold calls and got some pieces. Some worked really, really well, just like the piece that Joey had written for these guys just a second ago. It was a fantastic arrangement. Thank you, Joey, for that. But then in 2005, one of the greatest moments of my life happened, and my son was born. And he doesn't know this until right at this moment, but I asked Howard Rowe, would you write a piece for my kid? And he said, I would love to. He said, I've been working on it. I have something in mind, and I'd be happy to do that for you. So some time went by, and he sent me a demo recording and said, what do you think about this piece? And I said, I think it's perfect. And he said, okay. And I said, Howie, how much do I owe you? Because these things cost some money, $500,000. Joey, did you get $1,000 from? And he said, no, okay, all right. So you got to up the rate there. Whatever it was, and he said, Andy, I'm just happy to do it for you. I had known Howie for a considerable time at that point. Met him when I was in high school. He played in the pits of orchestras when I was in high school, starting out with Johnny Cassino as an eighth grader, born hand jive, baby. But anyway, he was playing in the pits for there. I got to know him. Then when I moved back to the area, he had me play with him in various situations. And sadly, Howard just passed away this past Sunday. So unfortunately, he won't hear this week. Well, he's listening. We know he's here. But as friends and I have reminisced a little bit, one of the things that comes back, in addition to be a fantastic composer, arranger, trumpet player extraordinaire, he was just a genuinely great individual. A guy that walks in the room and asks how you're doing before you have the chance to say how are you? So anyway, this is Alexander's Ragtime Band, which we first played in 2005. Now I get to do this on the other side. Thank you, Mrs. Valenti, for giving me this opportunity. It's an honor.
Thank you very much. Before we play our last tune, I just need to say a couple thank yous. First and foremost, thank you to CPAX, Gordy, and our light and sound crew, always illuminating us through our concert season, making us sound, or at least being heard on the live stream. So thank you to everyone up in the booth that has been here all the past 4 weeks, and we got one more concert to go. So thank you to everyone there. Thank you to the music department, K through 12. It is impossible to do all of this without everyone starting at the young age. So thank you to everyone K through 12. Of course, our administration and Board of Ed, thank you for your support. And it's been an honor and a privilege to work with the Blue Notes this year. I told them in the band room, I'm not lying to them, that they are a fantastic group of musicians, but more importantly, they are fantastic humans. And it's been a true pleasure to work with all of them. So thank you all. And I just want to take a moment to acknowledge our seniors. They had their acknowledgement a couple weeks ago, but it's really important that at this concert as well, their last concert at Brockport High School, that they are acknowledged. So can all our seniors please stand or wave from the back, please? Please stand. Please stand. So when I took over the Blue Notes over the summer, or I knew I was going to be directing the Blue Notes that Mr. Hallquist had conducted in the past, I actually surveyed some alumni and I blasted it out to a bunch of people. I said, what is your most memorable chart from being in Blue Notes? Not one, not two, not three, but many people came back and said, Madrid by Eric Morales. So hasn't been on the program in a while, and I'm excited that we're going to play this because it's not only probably a lot of their favorites, hopefully it's some of their favorites, but it's definitely a favorite of mine. So this is Madrid by Eric Morales. Thank you again. This is the Brockport High School Blue Notes. Thank you.
So I've been rehearsing it in the wrong order. So just so you know, we're starting with Ever, Ever After. Do you love the movie? You don't know what I'm talking about. Well, you're gonna go, oh yeah, I've heard that, when they sing this awesome, awesome song, awesome message, and it doesn't feature anybody, right? It's teamwork. So, this is a pretty eclectic program, and I heard this song. I'm not really up on pop culture. I don't know what I'm busy doing, but I fell in love with this arrangement when I heard it in a preview track, and so I wish this for you, a crowded table. And Aspen's going to be featured, so keep an eye out for them coming down. All right, crowded table. Thank you.
want a garden, we're gonna have to sow the seed. Plant a little happiness, let the roots run deep.
If it's love that we give, then it's love that we reap. If we want a garden, you're gonna have to sow the seeds. Yeah, I want a house with a crowded table and a place by the fire for everyone. Let us take on the world.
All right. I know you're probably surprised that it's going to be still daylight when the concert's over, right? Especially if I was on it. So I want to just recognize our seniors here. It's a really special group to be with, and they work very hard. And great leadership. Patty, thank you for coming here to be with us. You add so much to our mix and your flexibility. So first year, a Bella Voce singer, Patty Sturck. And these three all came together in that it was crazy. We have pictures. They sat here, they sang with microphones 12 feet apart so they could hear each other. But thanks for coming in those hard times to bring the next wave through. So Indigo, thank you. 3 years, Indigo Pardon. And Jenna Rivera, 3 years. Holding down that alto two part, those two. And Sunny, thanks for coming and being so devoted to whatever part we needed you to sing, I think. So Sunny Amoroso, 3 years. And Riley. Riley's been here for 4 years, singing her heart out. Congratulations on everything you're achieving and giving to us. Noah Helquist, thanks so much. Every step of the way. Every step of the way is there for us. Yeah, truly a collaborator, and we really appreciate all that you give. Whew. So this is, this has been a real honor for me to be able to work with these young people and all the singers and how the wonderful musicians down the hall that stop by and say hi, or if I say hi, they go, oh, hi. You know, you're wonderful people. And we do great things together because of music. Why am I crying? It's my last time conducting on this stage, and it really has been an honor. And this song, there are four girls probably watching that, besides my sisters, that taught me how important this song was, but four girls listening tonight, and I knew I needed these singers to sing this. You've got a friend, Carol King, none better, and they do a great job with it. So it's kind of like a mantra around here. We have friends in music. So thanks so much. It's been great, and wait till you hear them. It's awesome.
Begins to blow.
Thanks so much for coming tonight. We do have a senior cabaret night kind of thing going on tomorrow night at 7 o'clock in the LGI if you want to come down and check out what seniors are doing in choir. And a couple of band kids are coming down to show off a little. And, of course, we have NISMA Festival Monday. You've all heard practicing, right? And then I think the final concert, Tuesday the 6th, right? OMS Orchestra. So hope to see you there. Have a great night.
Super job. Super job. Head on.